Hello, my name is Brian. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to configure console users and create console user roles to support knowledge advanced workflow. Navigate to the Users tab. Click List next to Console Users. The first user I am configuring is the admin. I do not want the admin receiving Spanish content requests, so I am unchecking Espanol. Notice the role that has been assigned. For the reviewer, I'll do the same thing as I had for the admin. I am just unchecking Spanish. For the translator, I do not need to change anything in the console user settings. I will now define my console role, Knowledge Advanced Access. Click List next to Console Roles. Notice the roles have all been created automatically based on the profiles we created earlier. For the admin role, I'm pretty much just going to grant every administration permission. The only piece I don't want for them is to be responsible for workflow approvals. They'll still have the power to create workflow and to manage tasks that appear in the inbox. The reviewer role is responsible for approving channel content before it is made public. Workflow tasks will appear in the inbox, requesting approval of documents, so I need to be sure to give them an inbox. Also, for tasks that are not directly assigned to me, I would like to be able to assign them from a pool to myself. The FAQ channel is where I'll be conducting reviews, so I need to have some access to that channel. View, modify, and delete are the most important. I will also grant the reviewer the power to check documents back in that have been checked out by another console user. For example, if someone checks a document out to prevent others from editing it, but they have gone on personal emergency, and when they're out of office, no one else can edit the document, it would be great for someone to be able to remove that lock. I am selecting the workflow step for when a reviewer role will participate in approvals. For the translator, we need all the same settings as the reviewer. Additionally, we need the translate power within the channel we are responsible for. I do not want translators to participate in workflow approvals, so I will leave that unchecked. I have completed a basic setup of Knowledge Advanced console users. I'll be using these roles when I demonstrate workflow in the next tutorial.